Today on Upfront, the sweeping plan to shake up the Milwaukee County Board. Why is the state stepping in? Then the changes that might be coming in education reform in Wisconsin. And the Supreme Court candidate who's posted anti-Governor Walker videos on YouTube. Can he judge a case related to the governor fairly? It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Coucher.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. Wisconsin's only full-time and best-paid county board could be in for a big shakeup. A new state lawmaker is proposing a bill that would dramatically slash the salaries of Milwaukee County supervisors, as well as the board's budget, make the board part-time. The changes would be put to a vote of Milwaukee County residents. The 18 members of the Milwaukee County Board earn nearly $51,000 a year. The chairwoman makes $71,000. Wisconsin's other biggest counties, Dane County's 37-member board, is part-time at a salary of $8,200 a year. 24 part-time supervisors on the Waukesha County Board earn just over $9,500 a year. We're talking about this today with Republican State Representative and former Milwaukee County Board member Joe Sanfelippo, who's the author of the bill, and Democratic Senator Jon Erpenbach of Middleton, who's at our Madison affiliate, WKOW-TV. Gentlemen, thanks very much for being with us today. Representative, let me begin with you, since this is your legislation. This will cut salaries from roughly to $15,000, cut the county budget in Milwaukee County from 6.6 to 1.2. It's cheaper government, but is it better government?
Yes, I think it is. And the reason I think this change is important is if you take a look at Milwaukee County had a part-time board up until the late 1970s. And when the board kind of transformed itself from part-time into full-time, it started getting into a lot of friction areas with county executives. And I know it's been highlighted more recently with our current county executive and Governor Walker when he was county executive. But the history shows that there has been tension between the board and the county executive ever since the board went to a full-time position.
And you think having a part-time board will remove that tension?
Definitely. If you take a look at what the board accomplished in the 60s and 70s when it was part-time, it did a much better job of managing the county's business than the full-time board does today.
Let me bring Senator Erpenbach into this conversation. Democrats in the state legislature seem to be pretty cool to this idea. Why is that?
Well, I don't know, Mike. I can't speak for all Democrats. I just know, and this isn't in defense of the Milwaukee County supervisors. The problem I have with this, Mike, is it's the fact that it's the state of Wisconsin, it's the state legislature coming into Milwaukee County and saying, this is how you're going to run your county board. And back, I think it was 1985, the legislature passed and the governor signed into law giving counties autonomy to run their counties the way they choose to do so when it comes to compensation and so on. So again, I'm wondering as a state senator from Middleton, why am I sticking my nose into Milwaukee County like this?
You say this is a matter of local control, but in essence, because the voters of Milwaukee County would vote on this, are they not asserting local control?
Well, when I talk about local control, this has never been a campaign issue as far as I know within Milwaukee County. Maybe it was for Joe when he first ran for county board in Milwaukee County. But if this is really all about local control, then you would think this would be a big campaign issue come springtime for the county board elections. And basically, it would be a referendum on that. If you have a candidate who is supporting downsizing the board or cutting their pay and that candidate wins, then go ahead and have at it. But again, it's the state legislature going into Milwaukee County and saying, this is how much you're going to pay your board. Imagine, Mike, if Congress came into Wisconsin to the state legislature and said, okay, this is how you're going to run your legislature and this is how much you're going to get paid. Again, to me, it's really more a matter of we have better things to do in state government. I don't know how this creates jobs, which is what we're supposed to be all about right now. So again, it's something where I'm not comfortable with as a state senator from Middleton, from Dane County, going into Milwaukee County and telling them what to do with their county board.
Let me have you respond to that, Representative.
Sure. First of all, I'd like to make a couple of points. The analogy between Congress and coming into the state really isn't apples to apples. The county government was created by the state. So therefore, county government is really an arm of the state. The state could come in and has the right to say if the county isn't performing properly, the state can make some changes. In fact, I would argue that the state doesn't have not only the right, but it actually has the obligation to take care of problems in the county, as it has in the past. You know, at least two other times in the past, the state had to step in and clean up a mess that the county had when it took over the Bureau of Child Welfare and when it took over the Income Maintenance Service Division. And so it's incumbent, just as if the DOT or the Department of Health Services wasn't functioning properly, the state needs to step in and clean up the mess here.
Senator, I'll give you a chance to respond to that.
Yeah, you're right. If the DOT isn't performing, we're supposed to step in and clean it up. The DOT is the Wisconsin Department of Transportation. And again, when Joe was on the county board for 5 years, he took the full salary, which is about $50,000 a year, plus the benefits. Now, I'm not doubting Joe's sincerity on this, but when he had an opportunity to take $15,000 a year for the county board work, which is what his bill does, he didn't. He took $50,000. So again, if this is something Milwaukee County wants to do, then let the county board do it. If the current county board isn't going to do it, then elect county board members who will. To me, it's that simple.
I know you want to respond to that, so go ahead.
Sure. I mean, listen, I'm all about equal treatment, okay? When I was on the county board, we passed 24 furlough days for county employees. I was the only county supervisor that every pay period I wrote a check back to the county treasurer, gave it to the clerk's office to pay back those furlough days, because I figured if I enacted a bill that was going to be put furlough days on county employees, I should partake in it myself. While I was on the county board, long before I even dreamed about running for the state assembly, I advocated for changing the pay. It would have affected me at that time just like it affected everybody else.
One of the arguments in this is that Milwaukee County should be like other counties. Isn't Milwaukee County different? It's bigger. Aren't its problems more complex? Isn't there a reason to have more oversight over what happens in a county the likes of which Milwaukee County is?
Well, if you take a look over the last several decades, Milwaukee County has been shrinking. We had 12,000 employees with a part-time county board. We now have 4,000 employees with a full-time county board. We were running a hospital. We were running a power plant. We were running services that the state has now taken over. So everywhere in Milwaukee County government, the government has shrunk, but at the same time, the county board has grown in size and grown in budget costs. So what I'm saying is we need to take a look at this and do equal treatment, downsize the board just the way the rest of the county has downsized. And if I could just add one last point.
Very quickly.
John mentioned, why would a senator from Middleton be interested in this? Because Milwaukee County is like the economic engine for the entire state. What's good for Milwaukee County is good for the state. And the governor's budget's going to focus on five priorities. Right. One of those is government reform. Milwaukee County is the best place to start.
Senator, you get the final word here.
Well, I think when it comes to government reform, we have to reform what's going on in the state of Wisconsin, not just one particular county. And if I understand this right, this legislation just affects one particular county. It's not the entire 72 counties in the state of Wisconsin. On the issue of fewer public employees, and there very well may be fewer public employees, but I guarantee you they're contracting out a lot more in Milwaukee County than they used to back in the 60s and the 70s that Joe is talking about. Again, we have larger fish to fry here in the state of Wisconsin. What we need to do is we need to focus on the economy. We need to create jobs. We need to make sure that we have funding for schools and so on and so forth. State issues. And what we're doing, Mike, is we're talking about 33 state senators, 99 state representatives, talking about one particular county and how much those county board members get paid. I just think we're kind of wasting time. If Milwaukee County wants to do it, Milwaukee County will do it.
Senator Jon Erpenbach, the Democrat from Middleton, Representative Joe Sanfelippo, the Republican from Milwaukee County. It's good to have you both on the program.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Appreciate it. And
we
put together a comparison of Milwaukee County's board with some other similar county governments around this nation. You'll find that on our website, the upfront section of WISN.com. Coming up next, what's in store for education reform in Wisconsin? And later, the Supreme Court candidate seen praying for Governor Walker on YouTube. He says his campaign is serious. That's when Upfront continues.